Hey, hello everyone, bonjour, welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril, I used to be a stem cell researcher for many years, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. And for today, I have a very exciting video, or at least for me, it is very exciting. I am going to talk about and review the brand new Anessa sunscreen that I got thanks to one of you who sent me all of them from Japan, because Anessa is owned by Shiseido and it is a Japanese sunscreen brand. And oh my god, the new editions of some of those sunscreen are simply amazing. And before I start, I want to tell you a couple of things. So first of all, if you are into Japanese products and also sunscreen, there is one website that I highly recommend. This is from the blogger Radzilla. So I'm going to put the link to her blog down below in the description box. So definitely check her out, because this is an amazing content. And the other website is of course simply the website from Anessa, where you will have a little bit more information about the sunscreen if you want to, and they have an English version which is perfect for us. In addition, I wanted to have swatches on darker skin tone, because this is something that is so important. Almost nobody talks about it, but whatever your skin color is, you have damage from UV, and obviously the higher the sun protection is, so the SPF and the UVA protection, the better it is for everybody. If you already have a darker skin tone, this rich chocolatey rich tone, you are very lucky, because you already have a built-in SPF, but that doesn't mean that the UV are not going to damage your skin. So you also need to wear a sunscreen, and you will see that in the Anessa range, there are some sunscreen that are perfectly suitable for darker skin tone. So I'm going to start with the Iconic Milk, which is the perfect UV sunscreen skincare milk. SPF 50+, PA rating of 4+, because all the sunscreen that I'm going to show you will only be SPF 50+, PA rating of 4+, and I strongly discourage you to go below SPF 50+. So because I am going to review a lot and a lot of sunscreen, I am only going for this one to tell you, I would say, a little bit more of the filters and the UV protection. And for the rest, I'm just going to write them down and tell you really quickly about the filters, because it will be easier. And before I tell you about the filters about this bad boy, I want just to highlight something, and you will see how crazy the new one is. Currently in Europe, and actually in most sunscreen that I know of, there are four filters, like in this one for example, the La Roche-Posay, the Ultra Cream. This one has a mind-blowing 6 filters and a lot for UVA protection, which is excellent. What you want, especially in a very high protection sunscreen, you want to have redundancy for UVB, UVA type 2 and also UVA type 1. This is one of the many things that makes a sunscreen outstanding in terms of sun protection. The new edition of the Perfect Milk has 8 filters. This is insane, I've never seen it in the market, and still the texture and the overall, I would say, application, etc., is still pretty matte, not overly greasy, I mean, crazy. So let's dive in. So first filters is zinc oxide. This is a broad mineral filter that filters UVB, UV type 2 and UVA type 1. By the way, zinc oxide is a mineral UV filter, and it is also a chemical filter. Then we have octinoxate, which is a UVB absorbent. Octocrylene, again, a UVB absorbent. Octisalat, again, a UVB absorbent. Uvinol A+, which is a beautiful UVA mini type 1 UV filters. It also absorbs a little bit of UVA type 2. Titanium dioxide, a mineral based UV filter that absorbs UVB, UVA type 2, a tiny bit of UVA type 1, but not much. Polysilicone 15, which is an excellent UVB absorber. So this one is actually a chain of silicone where we have chromophores that are going to absorb the UVB. What I like about it is that it is not like a tiny molecule, it is a bigger molecule. And the last one is the Chinozob S Aqua. So Chinozob S Aqua is also a broad spectrum filters that absorb UVB, UVA type 2 and UVA type 1. And this one is also very similar to the Chinozob M in the sense that it also absorbs a little bit of visible light. So this combination of filters is just mind-blowing. Also, keep something in your mind that the Tinos of S Aqua is an encapsulated filters. And this is also very clever because you have the conventional, I would say, filters, so they are very tiny. You have this polysilicon 15 that is a little bit bigger. Then you have medium range with the Tinos of S Aqua. So in the end, you will have a veil of sunscreen with different size. And this is going, of course, to have a more even layer of UV filters, which is exactly what you want. So overall, this UV combination is insanely good. And this is definitely one of a kind. If you go to the NSA website, you will see that this one is in the lineup with no tan. And this one is described by having the highest protection. Unfortunately, they don't disclose the exact value of the SPF and the exact value of the UVA protection. What I can tell you about the old versions of this one, sorry for the sticker, I was not able to remove it. That was the one that I've used the most through the years, and also in very hardcore situation, especially during my last trip in Asia. I was in Malaysia, it was extremely hot, extremely humid, and whatever sunscreen that you put are just sliding on your face because you are a sweaty mess, basically. So it's very difficult to have a strong layer of sunscreen. And I can tell you about with this one, even by spending the whole day outside, not in the shade, I didn't tan at all. And this is also why I highly recommend this one. This is one in my hardcore categories. Also, something very interesting is that on my partner, he has medium skin tone. When you have medium skin tone and you are exposed to the sun, after like 10 to 15 minutes, you will see a darkening of the skin, which is a change in the conformation of the melanin, so it darkens immediately. This is not a tanning reaction. And this is a good way to see if a sunscreen is good or not, and my partner didn't tan at all and I didn't observe this change of color. So this is also why I really trust this sunscreen. So in addition of this, it has crazy technology. So the first one is the new one. This is actually the only sunscreen that I know with a technology like this. It is pretty mind-blowing. This is the thermal booster technology. And what does it mean? It means that the UV protection becomes higher when the skin reaches 37 degrees. So pretty crazy. Unfortunately, NSA does not disclose of how much this protection increase. But still, I find it very interesting because most of the time when you are at such a high temperature, it means that you are in extreme condition, so you do need an extreme sunscreen. So in addition to this, it also have the Aqua Booster technology that the previous version also had. So this technology means that the UV protection becomes stronger when it is in contact of water, whatever it is, from the sea, from the swimming pool, or simply because you are sweating. Again, this is something that is so useful because when you are sweating, for example, it will disturb the layer of sunscreen, which is not going to happen with this one. Like I said, I have a lot of experience with this one, and I can tell you that this one is so bulletproof. This is crazy. So I recall that years ago, the way that NSA described this technology is that it was an increase of 20% of the protection. So if it is the case, it means that if this one is an SPF of 60, most likely it is higher than this, but I cannot tell you because I don't know. But SPF 50 plus equal SPF 60 or above. So if we consider that this is an SPF of 60 in contact of water, it means that the increase would be of 20% if it's still true, or even higher, let's dream. So it means that it turns into an SPF of 72. So just to give you like a little idea. In addition to this, it is also friction proof and very waterproof for 80 minutes. And I have to say that the waterproof and the friction proof technology is again very mind-blowing, because when you apply it, even when you have a shirt that is going to have friction with the sunscreen, it is not going to transfer to your clothes, because this one has a tiny white cast and you don't see it on your clothes. Also, if you apply it on your hand, you want water on top, you will see that the water is repelled by the sunscreen, and even if you rub it under water, it doesn't move. This is insane. Also, something that is pretty amazing is with one solid coat, even 10 hours after, I still have the waterproof film on my skin. I did it on my face but also on my arms. This stuff doesn't move at all. It is crazy. It is also described to be sebum proof. Of course, that doesn't mean that you don't need to reapply, but it means that if you know that you are not going to reapply your sunscreen for whatever reason, you have better insurance than with this one. You will still have a pretty high protection 6 hours after, which I really like. So as you can see, it does have a white cap. This is not a terrible one. I have a video to determine exactly how much sunscreen do you need on your face. Just spend some time to try to figure it out, because if you just apply the correct amount, you will see that the white cast is not that crazy. If of course you don't over apply, I always tend to over apply when I am on vacation, but I just put it out there. So the two cons of this one is that it has alcohol and also perfume. So obviously, if you are sensitive to perfume and to alcohol, don't use it. I have to say that I'm pretty sensitive to alcohol. I've never had any problem with all the NSI sunscreen. Actually, in terms of perfume, I know this is not something that is ideal at all, but if I have to choose between a hardcore beautiful sunscreen that also has a beautiful finish because it brushes the pore, you don't look crazy, you don't look shiny, it is pretty, it is very elegant on the skin, especially for a protection like this. So if I have to choose between this and the perfume, and and the UV damage, even though it has perfume, the UV damage always win for sure. So if you're not sensitive to perfume, definitely try it out. Last but not least, the difference is of course the new technology, the thermo booster, and also the mind-blowing combination of filters. The other difference is that this one is slightly more moisturizing than the previous one, but it is still pretty matte. It also needs often a tiny bit more time to set compared to the previous one. One last thing is that if you have very dry skin, this one will be pretty dry on you. So what I do, because currently in Paris, the air is pretty drying, so if I just apply it, it can dry out my skin. I just increase my moisturizer, I go hard with my moisturizer, and then I'm fine. So the next one is the mild version of the milk. So this one is aimed to be used on babies, children, and of course of adults with sensitive skin, and I really, really like this one, especially for those of you who are sensitive to a lot of sunscreen. If you want to have a hardcore one that doesn't have a white cast as strong as only a mineral-based sunscreen, this one is definitely worth a try. It is perfume-free and alcohol-free. So in terms of filters, it has zinc oxide, titanium dioxide, Uvenol A+, and Tinozol S. So this is a very, very safe combination of filters with a lot of redundancy, which of course I love. In terms of technology, this one is also friction proof, which is amazing. This is also water resistant for 80 minutes, like the Perfect Milk, even though I find this one even, I would say, more resistant to water than this one, than the Mild Milk. It has also the Aqua Booster technology and a noticeable white cast. For sure, this one has a stronger white cast than the Perfect Milk. There is no doubt about this, as you can see on the swatches. Again, if you know the exact amount that you need on your face, yes, the white cast is stronger than the Perfect Milk, but it's still, I find, workable, especially on fair skin like mine, or even on medium skin. If you don't mind to have like a brighter skin tone, it is still elegant to wear. You can also wear makeup. So something that you need to understand with this one is that it does have an oily feeling. I do find that compared to the previous version, it does set a little bit faster and also better. So the oily feeling is not coming from oil. So therefore, if you are acne prone and you have oily skin, you can still use this one. This is coming from the mix, I guess, of silicone. So what I invite you to do is you apply it, you wait for at least 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, you just powder the area that you need to, such as the T-zone, but for a sensitive skin, I really love this one, especially if you are starting, you wear on isotretinoin, for example, aka Roaccutan, you have a pretty hardcore skincare treatment for your acne, for example, this one is definitely worth a try, especially when you spend a lot of time outside. So now let's move on to the gel version. So the Anessa Perfect UV Sunscreen Skincare Gel, ooh la la. So I cannot comment on the previous version because this is the first time that I try it. I also really, really like this one. So in terms of filters, it has octinoxate, octisalate, Tinozop S, Uvenol T150, Uvenol A+, and also titanium dioxide. So again, the combination of filters is so, so on fleek. I really love it. You have a lot of redundancy on this one. So this one also features the Aqua Booster technology, which I love. It also has the anti-friction technology, which I like. It doesn't have the Thermo Booster. This is only the Perfect Milk that has it. This new formula is supposed to provide a more long-lasting protection. Again, I never know what it exactly means. What I can tell you is that also the waterproof film does stay pretty long on me, but I cannot really be sure. If you are under a lot of sun, choose the Perfect Milk. This is the one that also Anessa said that has the strongest UV protection. I do find that on a day-to-day basis, especially if you have more normal to dry skin, this one is simply beautiful. The white cast, as you can see, is pretty minimum to almost non-existent, unless you have super dark skin tone. It is also an excellent makeup base, which I really enjoy. Again, it has perfume and also alcohol, and all the sunscreen actually has the same sort of citrusy smell that doesn't linger on myself, by the way. So now let's talk about the Anessa The Perfect UV Sunscreen Skincare Spray. This one, hence the name, comes in a spray. It is very, very fine, like extremely fine, which is a good thing because when you are going to spray your skin, you want to have a super even coat and don't have like big drops of a sunscreen. You want to have an even layer. So first, let's have a look at the filters. So it's Octinoxate, Octocrylene, Polysilicon 15, Juvenal T150, Juvenal A+, and the last one is Tinozop S. Again, an excellent UV combination. This one is also in the Suntan lineup from Anessa, which I really like. So this new version is also supposed to be more long lasting, whatever it means. It also features the Aqua Booster technology and the anti-friction technology. It is water resistant for 80 minutes. So this one also contains alcohol and perfume, similar to the other one. So most of the time I am pretty opposed to those formulas, like for example this one from Skin Aqua, the Sarafit. So yeah, this one is almost invisible on the skin. It is very pleasant, very dry, and etc. But you don't, it is impossible to know exactly how you meet, because the moment that you spray it, it just disappeared completely. And I'm really against this, because remember that if you under apply your sunscreen, you will not have the protection, which is something that you want. With this one, you can still manage to apply the correct quantity. If you're using one of those teaspoons, you just spray with it until you have the correct quantity. It is a little bit messy, I have to say, but it is still possible. So on the face, it is almost, the finish is normal to slightly matte. It is very, very beautiful. I love the finish that it gives to the skin. I also find it very practical, especially for your hands. So basically when you are on the go, you just spray your hands. You can also spray your feet, your arms. So you do several coats and then you massage it in to make sure that it's super even, and another coat. So it's very convenient. It is not sticky. It's not going to transfer on your clothes. So it's very excellent. If you go to the Anessa website, you can even use it to fix your makeup, and it works pretty well. If you do it, you just hold your breath, you do it on your face, and then you walk immediately, because you don't want to breathe the sunscreen. But in a day when you need like some really hardcore protection, what I would do is to use the Perfect Milk. This one, then you can add a layer of foundation, like I'm going to show you with the BB foundation, the Anessa BB foundation. You can put a little bit of powder if you really need to, and you can set everything with this. And like this, you can have a makeup day with a super high protection against UV, which I really like. This is a product that I really enjoy, but please be very, very careful to not over apply. Something that is beautiful, as you have seen, is that it has zero white cast. So the last sunscreen before I tell you about the BB foundation from Anessa is this bad boy right here, the Whitening UV Sunscreen Gel. So I have already talked about this one in two of my videos about tranexamic acid, because it contains tranexamic acid, which is an excellent ingredient if you are suffering from hyperpigmentation. So definitely go and check out my videos. So this one has Octinoxate, Juvenal T150, Tinozop S, and Juvenal A+. This is an excellent combination of filters. Again, it comes as a gel. It is a little bit more of a gel cream. This is very pleasant to use in terms of texture. This one, so the sunscreen skincare gel, is a little bit more creamier than this one that feels more lightweight. This one I highly recommend it for those of you who want to have an elegant sunscreen on a day-to-day basis, but you are suffering from hyperpigmentation. And tranexamic acid is very easy to work with because it is not going to irritate your skin like other brightening ingredients, I would say, to fight hyperpigmentation. So, and this is why I really like this one. Of course, if you have fair skin like mine and you know that you'll be exposed to a lot of sun, don't use this one, but choose, for example, the Perfect Milk on the day that you will go outside. But in the morning, you can straight away use this one. If you have normal to oily skin type, just use this one with no moisturizer. Just apply an hydrating toner plus an hydrating serum if you want to, and then the sunscreen. It works beautifully under makeup also. So this one is water resistant only for 40 minutes, so it's not ideal, of course, if you know that you will want more. So the last review for today is the Perfect UV Sunscreen Skincare BB Foundation, which is basically a foundation with an SPF of 50 and a PA rating of 4 pluses, which I really love. So just in terms of filters, it has zinc oxide, titanium dioxide, octinoxate, octocrylene, juvenile A plus, and tinosal S. So it is almost impossible to find a foundation or a BB cream, whatever the name, with such a beautiful combination of filters, because it really feels like a makeup product. It is very runny and pretty matte. It is not overly matte, so therefore, if you are using a shiny sunscreen, you can use this one to matte it down. So a good combo is with the Perfect gel, and then you apply the BB foundation if you need some makeup. It also, of course, works great with the Anessa the whitening gel and with the Perfect skincare gel milk, so the new version. Just keep in mind that those two combo is not the most perfect, but still it works pretty good. So why I wanted to show you this one is because you have fair skin like mine and you know that you'll be exposed to a ton of sun, but you still want to have this level of glam and you want some foundation. This combo will really protect and shield your skin from the sun, and still your skin will look, I would say, decent looking if you like to wear makeup. So this one, it also has the Aqua Booster technology. It is also water resistant, only for 40 minutes, and it is also supposedly sebum resistant. I have to say that it is a very, very long lasting, and I love the combination of filters. Of course, the big downside is that it only has two shades. So the shade that I have on myself, it shades number one. If you are fairer than mine, this one will be too dark for you, unless you like it, of course. You can, I think, from the shade number two, go for a little bit more medium skin tone. And of course, it only fits for those of you who have more olive skin tone with an undertone of yellow. So comment down below and tell me what you thought about this video, and if you have any questions regarding this product. If you like this video, please thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new, and to ring the little bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also check my Instagram account. I am Cyril Laurent. I have plenty and plenty of stuff here. Also, every Wednesday and every Sunday, I answer your skincare question, and sometimes I also go live to answer them. I thank you so much for being here, and I will see you next time. Au revoir.